Alright, hello everybody, and welcome back to another War Thunder video. So, we're in update 1.67. Update 1.65 was the full release of the game, or at least the release to say that it's now officially no longer an open beta test, like it has been for the past, like, 30 years. So, I had a look, over. Well, there was no looking. But I honestly haven't been doing very well at all in my top tier realistic. As you know, or might know, I've been grinding in realistic battles, playing whatever top tier premium or talisman vehicles that I use to grind. I've just been doing that all willy-nilly. And I finished the US, the Germans, and the Russians, and I'm on to the British and the Japanese. I can't do shit with the Japanese at 5.7. Which is weird considering that's where the tiger is, but for some reason it just isn't working out. And I was doing all right with the Centurion Mark 10, but all of a sudden I started to have shitty matches. 2 days ago I had shitty matches, yesterday I had shitty matches, and today I decided, okay, you know what, we're going to go old school, and we're going to skip the full-on grind, and I'm just going to go to what my next task would be, and that's eliting vehicles. Which is what I did. So I load up the lowest battle rating vehicles that aren't successfully or fully modified yet, and I put them in the lineup, and I made it up to battle rating 3.0 for the British so far with the Matilda Mark II and the 3-inch gun carrier. And the Matilda Mark II is fantastic at what it does. The 2-pounder gun is good and the armor is great. The problem is its battle rating. And the problem is that there's nobody really playing at this battle rating, so I'm constantly getting up-tiered into 3.7 and 4.0 battles. There are 3.7 tanks throughout this game. Stug 3Fs, as you can see there. There are Panzer 4Gs, Marder 3Hs, and various Japanese vehicles that are up there in battle rating as well. That's what makes the Matilda, in my opinion, kind of a rough thing to drive, because the 2-pounder gun is great at 3.0 and below, and it's okay at best if it gets up tiered. I mean, the fast reload is really the only thing it has going for it, but the fact that it's just such a slow vehicle and the armor is good, it's not good against the guns that I'm fighting, so I can easily be penned anywhere, no problem. Which is why I have to be very, very careful. Now, of course, trying to win the matches and earning RP is top priority when I'm trying to elite vehicles. And I've been doing okay for the past 5 or 6 matches I've played so far. There was a match where I really didn't do anything. Otherwise, I've gotten a few kills. There was one on Berlin that it was actually pretty fun, where I got killed in my Matilda, and I jumped into the 3-inch gun carrier, and that thing turns on like a dime when you're in neutral steering, which is just awesome. So I was able to. It was just me left on my team. I was the only one left against 2 enemy players, and they kept ganging up on me. But the 3-inch gun carrier held its own, I think, for about 5 different kills until they finally got behind me again. I crit them, but I didn't knock out their gunner or their gun, so they were able to shoot and finish me off. But we still won the match. And it's been fun. This one, here on Berlin, excuse me, I think I said something about Berlin before, I meant Advance to the Rhine. We're on Berlin right now. And I'm jumping into the Matilda Mark II, of course. And I have seen this problem constantly, especially in air. But it's been not too long since. I mean, only a matter of a couple days ago, I experienced this problem in the air, and that's with the kill credit system. The reason I mention that this is now in update 1.67 is because Gaijin still haven't done anything to the kill credit system. And I'm not talking about, oh, you're shooting at something and then someone else shoots it and they get the kill for it. I've talked about that too much. That is still a problem, but that's not the problem I'm talking about. The problem I'm talking about, is one that is very apparent, and I'm sure all of you have experienced in one way or another, probably too many times. It happened to me just a few nights ago when I was in aircraft. I tried to fly some realistic air when top-tier British really wasn't working for me at all. And this is the issue where you damage an enemy player so much, and then they either bail out or they crash, and you get 0 kill credit for it. This happened to me when I was flying the Hellcat Mark II, Mark III, Mark IV, I don't know, whatever the premium Hellcat for the British is. I was flying that, and there was an enemy BF-109 G2, and I avoided his pass and got on his tail, got a beautiful just spray across his wings multiple times. I blew off his ailerons, I killed his engine, and he went to glide right back into his airfield because they still had the A point on Norway. And he went to glide in, smashed into the runway, and died, and I got 0 kill credit for it. That's what I mean. That is a real issue. More so, in my opinion, than having your kill stolen when you honestly should have gotten the kill credit for it. Why is that an issue? Well, because you are still getting points in RP and Silver Lions, of course, for doing damage, but that's minimal compared to actually being rewarded with the kill credit, because then you get a massive boost in silver in RP. And of course, I only care about the RP, I don't care about the silver gain. And unfortunately, when this kind of shit happens, it can be pretty damn frustrating, especially for a player in my position that is trying to elite things. Now, I'm actually doing pretty well here. I'm already up on a few different kills and I've gotten an assist, but that doesn't excuse the fact that this is about to happen. And, I mean, yeah, you can already call what's going to happen. So I'm firing at this enemy. There you go. Right behind him, you could see something just spawned in. That is a Japanese NATO or NATO. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce it. We're just going to call it the anti-tank truck, armored truck tank thing. That's just what we're going to call it. That's just what we're going to call it for right now. We'll just call it the Japanese tank destroyer. I just saw it, and for a second, I thought maybe that was an 88mm flak half track. It's not, but they are in this match. You're going to see one spawn in at some point later. Anyways, I get a sneaky shot into a Stug 3, and I wasn't really planning to sit here and shoot at the spawn point. But the reason I am here is because I saw that enemy vehicle that saw me, and he's coming towards me. I get this awesome lucky shot right into his engine. I destroy his engine, but he can still move. So I don't know why he can still move. I destroyed his engine and caught him on fire, and I'm a bit stupid here. And I'm firing just shell after shell because I thought he was still there. In my opinion, I destroyed his engine and caught him on fire, but he was able to move. I was under the impression he was dead in the water there, but he wasn't. So, well, he's gone. It takes me a while to figure that out. See, I'm thinking like, oh, is he still there? Oh, wait, maybe he's not. I don't know. Is he? Anyways, this is the guy that we're talking about. So you can see I've damaged his engine, I've caught him on fire, and I've done some more damage to him. But that's barely anything compared to what I'm going to be doing to him. So we'll just keep watching the match here. He's somewhere behind that rubble, and I'm not really going to notice it yet. I can see an enemy vehicle just spawned in, and of course I'm going to be sneaky here and get myself probably a bit of a scummy kill. Try to. It is an SPAA anyways. So it's, I'm doing the world a favor. And I didn't notice, if you look right there on the right, you can see that enemy Japanese tank destroyer just pulled up, and I didn't realize it. So I fire my machine guns randomly, and I realize, oh, I hit something. He shoots, hits the rubble in front of me, so I pull out because I know I've got a minute, but I can't see shit, and I'm just firing willy-nilly. And then I try to get a shot into a Panzer III. M doesn't really work, and here comes an enemy reinforcement. So bam, I wound his loader and kill his gunner. So I've knocked out one of his crew members now. He's sitting there. Another shot. I knock out both his commander and his loader. I've now killed three of his crew members. He's still sitting there. At least I think he is. That's why I'm shooting. I hit him again. Then he gets gunner control back just after I hit him. So I shoot again. Miss. Pull back. Pull out. Bam. Killed his gunner. I've killed four of his crew members. He only has two left as far as I'm concerned. Otherwise, he'd be dead and I would have gotten kill credit already. And it's around this point where he's going to pull back. Now, he's nowhere near a friendly cap zone, so there's no way that he is going to be able to get a crew replenishment. Someone kills the Stug, and I fire thinking that he's still there. Now, there's barbed wire there. See that dark, like, black splotch? That's barbed wire The graphic is, from this distance, makes it look like a big black splotch, and I'm thinking that that's him. That's why I keep shooting, and I basically put the rest of my ammunition towards this guy because, well, I thought he was there. So I open up with my machine guns, and there's somebody there. Somebody's getting hit by my MG. So that's why I kept firing. Maybe it wasn't my MG, maybe it was the M10 that hit him. I don't know. But I fire again. And I fire again. And there's something there, but I can't tell if that's the MG doing that or if that's the plane shooting him. I can't tell. Or if I'm hitting him. I don't know. But I fire again. I've only got 8 shells left. I mean, the 2-pounder gun can fire off a billion bullets. Or bullets? Shells. And any second now, there's an enemy, bam, that enemy's dead. But then, in a handful of more milliseconds, when I fire this again, only have 5 shots left, take a look at the kill feed, and you'll realize that our good old friend in the Japanese tank destroyer just randomly, somewhat for almost no reason, I don't know if this was his doing or not, but it kind of sent me for a bit of a loop. As when I come back around the corner, I see an explosion, like somebody fires a gun. Somebody's even shooting at him with a plane. But right here, just watch this. A Martyr 3 just died. And right there. So the enemy Japanese tank destroyer, right when that explosion went off, as if he shot his gun or something, like killing himself with the cannon breech damage or whatever. I don't know. As if that's what happened. That's what it seemed like. Either way, you can obviously see that nobody got kill credit for it. I killed 4 of his crew. 4. The only thing he had left was one crew member. He had two, but he only had one because this is realistic and you have to be in a cap zone in order to use crew replenishment. Not to mention the engine damage and stuff that I had caused him in the initial encounter with him. Now, we waited around for a few minutes before he ended up just dying. Why does that seem really inconsistent? Well, because there are other times where I can damage an enemy tank and never see him until the end of the match, where a friendly kills him and I still get an assist for it. But this guy that I do heavy damage to just randomly dies, bails out, or disconnects from the match. Whatever, either way, his vehicle's gone. He doesn't disconnect from the match because he actually spawns in again in an SPAA in just a few moments. And I've only got 4 shells left. So, obviously, he didn't disconnect. He bailed out. He just decided, I can't use this vehicle anymore right now, or I want to drive something different. And despite the damage that I did to him, I don't receive kill credit for it. And that's a problem, because this game is apparently in its final release state, or meaning it should be working as intended. No longer are we supposed to be testing things. But the kill credit system is still as shit as it's ever been. Because not only can you do amounts of immense amounts of damage and still have someone else claim the kill credit, but you can have this shit happen. And it happens so often, more often in planes than it does in tanks. But this is just one of the minor examples of it happening and really pissing me off. Like, I was not a happy camper after this happened. I wouldn't have cared if I got an assist or anything. I wouldn't have cared. I would have just been like, oh yeah, okay, I got 5 kills or whatever, and oh, there's an assist, whatever, continue on with the match. I wouldn't have cared. But the pure fact that nobody even got credit for that, even though there were planes shooting at him, that M10, I don't know if he shot him, and the fact of all that damage I did to him, it didn't matter. He still got away with no kill credit being given to anybody. So it pissed me off. And I don't know, this was a bit of a, I wouldn't really call it a dick move, but it was a bit of a rude thing, something you never see me do. I come back because apparently somebody capped the C zone that was behind me at some point, and I didn't realize it. But I'm out of ammunition. And so And I think I actually get a really lucky kill on the ass. Well, I don't want to call him an ass hat, but whatever. I didn't get kill credit on him. But I have one shell left. I put three of my shells into him and didn't kill him, but did damage to him. And he's in his little SPAA. And there's enemies moving up, but I get this really lucky kill. There he is. He moves across, and watch this. What the hell was that? I don't even know, but I got the kill on him, so that was satisfying enough for me. But anyways, like I said, I wasn't in a good mood because of that. And I normally don't do this, but somebody said something into the chat, something about me having five kills, what's the problem, or something like that. I don't know, whatever. It didn't rub me the wrong way, but I for a second thought it was just 75 mm M3. And he's capping the zone. And then, as I come into the zone to get my ammunition back, he does this. He starts to drive in front of me out of the cap zone. So I thought this guy was trying to push me away from the cap zone for some reason. And that's probably not what was happening. It was probably all one big misunderstanding. But I mean, look at it. He sits in the cap zone the whole time, but when I approach, he starts to drive forward and drives out in front of me and out of the cap zone boundaries, which made me think he was trying to keep me from it, which is why I completely pushed him out of the way. You will usually never see me do anything like that in my tank, ever. I just assumed that this was the guy that had said something into the all chat, or excuse me, into the chat, and I thought that he was trying to keep me from the cap zone for whatever reason. And he goes to drive off, and I check his name. And then I checked the chat to see what the name of the person there was, and I see that it's not the same person. And I was like, shit. And I was going to say sorry, but I completely forgot as I was sitting here trying to reload my ammunition. So, I mean, you know, it's not one of those feature, or it's not one of those things that happens where I'm literally pissed off, I'm going to close the game, rage quit. It's just one of those things that really gets on my nerves because it's a gameplay feature that shouldn't be broken at this late state of the game. And there's really nothing that you can say to defend it because people have said, you know, what counts as an assist or what counts as a critical hit in the game. But that really makes no sense considering I can do that much damage to him, wait a few minutes, then he can bail out with nobody getting kill credit, while later on I can maybe graze someone's turret drive or something, not even jam his turret, but I can like do a little bit of damage, and 10 minutes later, somebody else kills him, and I still get assist credit for it. That's what I mean with it being so inconsistent. There are times where I can hit an enemy tank, and it'll be an undamaged. Then somebody else shoots and kills him, and I still get an assist for it, even though I got an undamaged, and it happened a few seconds or a few seconds later. And then there are times where I can hit an enemy tank, crit him, actually penetrate, kill a crew member, and then a teammate shoots and kills him right after, and I don't get any credit for it, not even an assist. This is what I mean. It's inconsistent, and it just simply doesn't work at all. And fucking hell, does it really piss you off in air realistic battles? There are on too many occasions where you can crit an enemy plane, and he crashes and dies because of that, only for it to result in him crashing, quote unquote, where no credit is given to you. He has to crash like 30 seconds after you crit him, otherwise you're getting nothing for it. That is a pain in the literal ass. Literally. Ground Forces, unfortunately, isn't free of that pain either, but it simply just works a little differently. Hopefully, Gaijin at some point sees videos that people post like this one and realizes that their system they think is working perfectly fine for kill credit is actually not working at all and is really, really shit. And it's probably one of the most shittiest features in the game in terms of working as intendability. But I'm going to get back to grinding modifications on these vehicles. So I will see you in the next War Thunder video.